everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Confidence is never a question when it comes to wide receivers, and these two are no different. It's the Eagles going up against the Rams. So now let's go to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, where Jim and Phil have the call.
Is ready to get this one underway. And Benny Cunningham is back deep here, awaiting the opening kickoff. We're underway here. Cunningham's going to drop to a knee here, so this will come out to the 20. There's been all kinds of buildup and anticipation, and now the rookie quarterback heads onto the field for his first series.
Yeah, I think things have changed so much over the years. These quarterbacks, especially these rookies, they're so much more ready to play than previous years. They get to throw the football a lot in college, a lot in high school, so they come in the NFL prepared and ready to go. Look at the defensive line. Everybody shifting to their left.
First down at the 20. Cunningham's handed the football. Brooks is there to make the tackle. Kenny Britt is a big target on the outside.
Kenny Britt's got to turn into one of the top 10 receivers in the NFL. The talent's there. He's big, fast, strong. He can catch the football. Stay out of trouble. Stay healthy and get it done.
It's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. Curley's got on the handle.
The Eagles defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line. They tackle the runner for a loss.
Loss of 3 on the play. This is third down.
Let's go. Right to the up.
Cunningham's taking it on the screen. The tackle is made at the 40-yard line.
It's third down, Jim. You expect the team to throw the football down the field past the chains to get the first down. No, they catch them off guard. They throw a screen pass, nice execution, and they get the first down.
First down at the 40. Gurley's going to take the handoff now. If this defensive lineup is going to have the better of it today, it must get a big performance from Connor Barwin.
Connor Barwin, Jim, why they like him down here in Philadelphia is because he's big, rangy, and tough. That's what you want from your outside linebacker.
Second and 10. And the flag is down.
Holding offense.
Third down after the penalty.
Let's go. Press to the up. Press to the up.
Out of the shotgun formation. To the sideline and complete.
Damon Austin. No doubt he was worthy of a first-round draft pick. One of the best highlight films I saw of any player ever coming out of college was him. He is exciting. He can take ordinary plays and make them into something special.
The Rams snap it at the 36. And that pass is just thrown away.
Coming to the line at the 36-yard line.
The Rams snap it at the 36. Brandon Graham has the sack.
There's a couple ways to get to the quarterback. Run over the tackle or run around him. It doesn't matter as long as you get the sack.
It's third down coming up. The Eagles at the line. Dime package. They'll go shotgun here. Flag. That's a ball that should have been caught.
Holding offense.
Hecker is back now. He'll be punting. It's going to sail out of bounds, trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner.
So the rookie quarterback will take the field, trying to improve week by week.
Well, he's getting some experience. It's not a lot, but it's enough to help him feel more comfortable and I think play better. He should do well here today.
Is lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. The Rams with two extra defensive backs in the dime.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Pulls it in for a gain of about five.
Well, when you throw the slant route, it's all about accuracy from the quarterback standpoint. Make sure you put it right on the receiver. He can catch it, protect himself. Good job that time, and almost gets a first down.
Second down here.
Let's go.
And Matthews has got it on the toss. Gaines is there to make the stop.
Matthews is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Third down following the run. Will go ground. Davis, the one who brings him to the ground.
Matthews is able to get it done that time. Why? Because he has the power and the will to make it happen. Third short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
First down here after the run. And he's going to slide feet first.
It's a rough game out there. Avoid hits at all costs. Good job that time by the quarterback sliding before he takes the hit.
For the offense today at running back, he came into his own in 2013. Ryan Matthews.
Hard to say this, but maybe his biggest detriment is the fact that Ryan Matthews just runs so hard, it's hard to stay healthy. He just goes after every play like it's going to be his last. He's a really good NFL running back.
It's now second down and seven after the 3-yard rush. The Rams defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. That's a gain of six.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up. Matthews takes it. Toss play. Running room. That's a gain of 10.
Matthews is able to get it done that time. Why? Because he has the power and the will to make it happen. Third and short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
Coming to the line at the 43. The Rams defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals. Well, that basic slant route, Jim, it's thrown and caught. It doesn't get a first down, but it was really well executed. The offensive line gave the quarterback time and sight lines so he could put the football on target.
The Rams lined up in the nickel.
Let's go.
The Eagles will take the snap from the 35. Reaches out and grabs it. And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run. Well, that's a terrific touchdown here late in the first, and they've now taken the lead.
Two touchdowns are terrific no matter what time you get them, though, Jim. But, hey, late in the first, what a way to answer for that offense. That was a really, really sharp drive.
The Eagles for the extra point. Extra point is good. This time as he takes a knee. The Rams heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative, get the defense off guard, make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
First down at the 20. Gurley's taking the handoff. That tackle was made at the 27-yard line.
Well, all we hear about this running back is, oh, he gets outside. It's all about his speed. Well, not that time. It was about his power. Good job of just running through that tackle.
One quarter complete, and we'll take a break as you're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Papa John's, where you always get better ingredients, better pizza.
The Rams still driving as the second quarter gets underway. The Eagles defense now is going to go nickel. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Running back in this league and you pick up first downs and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
It's first down as they head to the line.
Look at the defensive linemen talking. They're all now shifting to the left.
They hand it off to him again. Gurley's tackled down at the 32. The Rams run the risk right now of having to abandon the running game. Gurley's been off the mark, and that's a big reason why they're trailing in this one.
That's right. It hasn't worked. So what do you say? Don't be afraid to change. What you have to do, you call the plays. They give your team the best chance to win, and you better start changing the play call.
Over the middle, and incomplete that time.
Well, it doesn't get much worse than this, does it? You're losing the football game. Now you're looking at third and long, and look, there are no miracles in the NFL, I'll tell you that. So be smart. If the play is not there, don't force it. Dump it off and wait for the next time you get it.
The Rams need to get to the 42 for the first down. Push them back 5 yards with the false start penalty.
False start offense.
Third down after the penalty. The Eagles will come out in the dime. Out of the shotgun. Austin's got the catch and the first.
Rams put themselves in a terrible situation. Third long, but you know what? They got a lot of talent on the offensive side, and that was an awesome job of picking up that first down.
Now first and 10. Gurley's going to secure the handoff, searching for space to the right. Gurley's marked down at the 47.
The days of thinking you're just going to rush the passer, those days are over for defensive ends. Yes, you have to rush the passer, but you got to be able to stop the run. That was a great job that time.
Second down and 10. Gurley's hand the football.
Well, we still got a close game here, and you got to try to keep it that way. It's third long and lose the football game. Don't take a chance on the offensive side. Wait for your next opportunity.
Loss of a couple that time. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The Eagles come out in a dime packet. The Rams will set up. The 44 is the first down line. Third and 12 to go. It's hauled in by Benny Cunningham. Muscles through the defender. Kendrick's there to take him down.
Running backs are such a big part of the pass game now in the NFL. Look at this play. Able to take a short catch and get a long gain out of it. Nice job by the running back.
The Eagles with a nickel look here on defense. The Rams have it at the 39. Knocked down as he fires it. About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. Second and 10. And it's swatted away.
Well, there's no doubt what to do in a situation like this. You do not take a chance and put your team in a position where they have to make a big comeback in the second half.
This drive.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line now shifting to the right.
The Rams have it at the 39. The sack by Fletcher Cox. Mid midway through the second quarter, and the defense gets the ball back to the offense, looking to extend the lead.
Well, they got it rolling here as a football team. The defense did its job. Now can the offense, like you said, go out there and extend the lead, string some good plays together, and put this other team in a tough situation.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. The Rams defense comes onto the field after surrendering a touchdown on the last drive.
Well, they're hoping for better results, no question about that, Jim. They got to come out, they got to hustle. There was not enough hustle last time, and the number one key for all defensive teams is play hard.
Way to call them out there, partner.
Hey, that's what I do. I call them.
Matthews in the backfield, single back set.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
First down at the 20. Middle of the field and incomplete this time.
Well, when there's man-to-man coverage on the defensive side and the defense does a job like this where they are covering those receivers, there is nothing a quarterback can do except that throw another incomplete pass.
Get ready. Press to the air.
Second down and 10. Through the second quarter, and they're putting themselves in good shape for halftime.
Yeah, they are. That was a nice drive for a touchdown, but I'm looking at the defensive side. It's time for the captains on the defense to give everybody else a talk and shape things up and get back in this game.
The Eagles for the extra point. The point after is good. The Eagles' defense will now be ready to get on the field. Their offense moved the ball over 80 yards on that last drive. Really no answer for them on what was a very impressive drive. Austin's going to start his return. Breaks at the tackle. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. And Todd Gurley runs onto the field. They've fallen behind here, and maybe it has something to do with the fact that he hasn't really been able to do anything on the ground to this point.
Oh, I think it's everything to do with why they're behind in this game so far here today, Jim. And listen, the coach has got to call some different plays. What they've been running has not worked. Time for a different look. The D-lines, they're seeing something on the offensive side. Everybody's shifting to the left.
Gurley's got it. Try over again on second down.
The defensive lines all shifting to the right. They're going to try to find a way to pressure the quarterback.
From the shotgun, Gurley's ready to run off the screen. Brought down at the 26.
Well, when you get in a situation like this, Jim, and you get third long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back, because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short.
Stands in the pocket, and they sack him on third down, and they force the quick three and out.
When you put on third down, you hope to get to the quarterback. Here's why. Because there are less defensive backs back there, the chances of giving up the big play are pretty high, but the rush, they're quick enough, they get there, they sack the QB.
All right, so coming out of the break, just 2 minutes to go, and a fourth down coming up in this one. Sproles has got it at the 19. Gains a Eagles have had a smart and snappy first half, and that's reflected on the scoreboard.
Sounds like the way I dress, smart, snappy. That is me. But, you know, hey, it's been a good first half for the offense. They want to keep it going. I'm sure they will.
Now makes the move to the right. After running it, it's second down. The Rams defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The defense had that one covered. Third down now. The Eagles come to the line. First down marker at the 40.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
And this will be incomplete. It'll be a three and out.
Huff's not able to come up with the catch. And a lot of times when you see a receiver drop a pass, they take their eyes off it. That's one thing. Or they're just trying to get it in their hands too quick. Why? Because they're trying to make some yards after the catch. That was the problem that time.
Austin's got it now. James, 16.
Austin's such a great athlete. You've got to find ways to get the football to him. Here's another way to get it to him. On a punt return, how explosive is he? Man, very. That's the answer.
The Rams have failed to come away with points on three consecutive drives. Their offense takes the field again now. What's caused them to go silent here, partner?
Listen, let's give all the credit to the defense. They're being very creative on the defensive side. The coach is calling the right plays, and they are just taking it to the offense right now. The more aggressive team is winning, and that's the defense.
He was looking for Austin, but this pass goes incomplete.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, the effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
Second and 10 coming up. The Eagles lined up in the nickel.
Get ready.
Dropping back now into the shotgun. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
Always try to save the timeout or timeouts when you can. And one way to do it is go for the hurry-up offense. Good job.
And that pass is just thrown away. They're set to punt it away now. The fake is on, and they're looking to pick up the first.
Well, I love seeing plays like this, a fake punt. When you throw the football and it doesn't work, hey, it's easy to do these things in practice. But when you got to do it in the game, you can feel the pressure, you get tight, and sometimes you just cannot execute the play.
The Rams' defense forced the three and out the last series.
You know what they did? They went out there and whooped the offense. You know what I mean by whoop? That means you just dominate, and they did it.
The Rams go with the dime formation here on defense. Matthews has the catch. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. There is a flag out.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty. Defense now is going to go nickel. Matthews on the screen. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage. The Eagles signal for the timeout, and that's the first one they've used. Final 30 seconds of the first half, and it's second down. The Eagles with an empty backfield look here.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Snapping out of the gun. Takes the hit and throws.
Well, every coordinator in the NFL has a box over there somewhere in that play sheet for third and long. When he wants to try to pick the play up or the first down with a throw down the field, it could be seams, double moves, but they have four or five of those types of plays to pick up third and long situations.
Pass is intercepted. Randall's going to make the tackle. Looking at the highlights now, here's a quarterback who has handled the pressure well today, Phil.
If they find a way to win this game, I'll tell you what, he is going to be very proud when it's over to play well in such tough conditions. When the offensive line struggles, that's pretty good stuff.
Not much has gone right for this team, Phil, but the interception might just be the spark that the offense can feed off of before halftime.
Yeah, if you want a spark on the offensive side, you got to get the offensive line to play better. When they play better, it helps all the skilled people. That's what needs to happen right now.
Gurley's met after a gain of three. The Rams call a timeout, their first. After the two-yard carry, it sets up second down and eight. Drop back, shotgun formation. Gurley has the good catch. And Brooks is there to make the tackle. That timeout by the offense. The Rams come out with a split backfield. First down at the 49. The sideline.
Good route that time by the receiver on the out route. Nice throw by the quarterback. This is what they call a timing route. Well, they were right on time.
This will be a field goal drive for Zuerlein. Possession for the offense. And that will close out the first half here in the city of brotherly love. We'll be back after halftime to Philadelphia for the beginning of the second half. All right, Larry, thanks a lot. Second half just about to get underway here as the special teams are about to head back onto the field. Gonna be a penalty here.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Boy, if his head got yanked back the other way. An obvious face mask penalty, and that's a big one.
It's about safety of the players, too. That's why when you grab, hit the helmet in certain situations, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Don't grab the face mask. Matthews is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
Second and nine coming up. The Eagles take it from the 38. And now here's the toss.
Holding offense.
The defense accepts the penalty. Eagles take it from the 28. And the carry to Ryan Matthews.
Holding offense.
That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. It's now second down. The Rams with a nickel look here on defense. Now slashing to the right side looking for room. That's
It's a gain of 8.
It's not always about being safe on third and long. Every coordinator has a group of plays that they like on third and 15 plus. So it could be seams, double moves, plays where you catch the defense by surprise, and you can pick up a very tough first down situation. Look out for changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
And it's in the hands of Zach Ertz. The tackle is made, and the first down is picked up.
That's what you want to do, just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving, keep the defense guessing, make them react instead of attack.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. And the give to Ryan Matthews. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Matthews is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Second and 7 on the way. Quarters formation here for the defense. He'll get it again. And Matthews is marked down at the 41. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Let's go.
The Eagles snap it at the 41. That's Quinn making the stop.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt. When you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
And it's now 2nd down and 5 after running it on first down. Matthews takes his spot in the backfield. They bring in the extra tight end. They better hurry to get the snap. And it's just thrown away. The line of scrimmage, the 36.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
From the shotgun. Two hands on the football and has the catch. Gains 19. That's reception number 2 for him.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
First down following the long play. And Matthews has got it. Screen play. He's in for the touchdown, but hold on a minute. There's a flag down. There's a flag away from the football.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty. This will be the 8th play of this drive. The Rams defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Jarring hit that time. Knocks the ball free. Boy, that was some hit that time that knocked the ball out.
Yeah, it was a good hit, but listen, you can tell the receiver's expecting that big hit. I don't know why. You're going to get hit no matter what, so you might as well just go ahead and catch the football.
The Eagles from the 27. Ryan Matthews with the reception. Gains 14.
Jim, this time it's a halfback screen. Nice job by the quarterback. The halfback, good job after catching it. Picked up some good yards. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Third down and six.
Gets away from pressure.
First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, you're on the defensive side. You don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
First and goal from the six. Matthews has it out of the eye. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
Eagles in the end zone. And a comeback now is going to have to be a monumental one. That touchdown has them looking in pretty good shape.
Yeah, they look like they're in good shape on the offensive side. But listen, no lead is safe in this league. So you got to be alert. Be alert for trick plays and things that you haven't seen yet.
The Rams now have even more work to do to get back into this one. Scores 21-0. The Rams are ready to return the kick. Austin will test the coverage. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Rams have seen this game just get away from him as it continues to get worse. They've still got more than a quarter to play.
Well, look, it's been a good learning experience, and you realize how tough this game is. So learn what you're doing here in this last bit of the game and see if you can carry that over into your next contest. What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
The Rams all bunched up here as they get set at the line. The Rams have it at the 39. It's intercepted. They throw a pick here, Phil, and they'll be very pleased that we're nearing the final quarter so they can get this one over.
You know, sometimes when you're losing like this and you're playing so bad, you just feel like you can't get the game over with. It's amazing how it just keeps dragging on. And man, this has been a bad day, and like you said, Jim, it just continues.
And Matthews is tackled down after a gain of two.
If you want to run the football to success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
The Rams lined up in the nickel.
Let's go.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Randall's got it. First down. The Eagles will come to the line trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth. The ball is spotted at the 49. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. The pass is thrown to Jordan Matthews. If you look at these passing totals, it's easy to get a sense why they're leading right now.
Those numbers are absolutely outstanding. When you see these kind of numbers, that means the play calls were good, the offensive line had an outstanding day, and also the wide receivers, they found ways to get over.
Got the first, and he's got some space. Got a flag.
Blake Lock in the back. Offense.
It's an illegal block in the back, and they now will be backed up some yardage.
Yes, always remember as a blocker, you need to get your head in front of the defender, and you've got to get your front shoulder in front also to make it legal.
Let's go.
The Eagles take it from the 23. Jordan Matthews brings it in. And a gain of four.
If it was me, I would cover the short receivers and force this guy to throw it down the field. You're behind by a few points. You've got to try and force the issue. Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Ogletree makes the play.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Third and two. Ryan McDonald's out. The defense has the football. The number one thing they're concentrating on at this point is taking care of the football, Phil Simms. What an untimely point to give the football away, even with a lead.
You know, Jim, sometimes when I play golf, my number one thought is I don't want to make a bogey. But sooner or later, somewhere in that round, you know it's going to happen. So in football, it's a game of adversity. They fumbled, big deal.
Flag is out. That's a false start on the offense, and that'll cost them 5 yards.
False start. Offense.
What a difficult spot to be in from here. The Eagles defense now is going to go nickel. Gurley's going to take the handoff now. The Rams have tried a couple of different ways to get the running game going, but it hasn't paid off. Gurley's been stopped from the first quarter.
Running game has no chance. That's obvious. We've seen it here today. And it's time for this offense to open it up, quit trying to run the football, and throw it down the field.
Second down and 13. Kendricks got it. And a first. That's his first reception today.
Well, if you guard the tight end close, it sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms, they can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance, they get it done.
Let's go.
First down at the 19. Gurley's out there to receive the screen pass.
Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Loss of two on that play. Second and 12. Ben Cunningham makes the grab. Steps out of bounds.
Well, that's a great feeling, isn't it, for an offense to throw a short pass to the running back and get a long gain. This guy is in there because he can run it, he can catch it, and he can make things happen.
The Rams snap it at the 31. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle. The Rams come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide. Has his man. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
Lack of hustle, bad tackling, you name it. They allowed the short throw and catch to go all the way down the field for a score.
The Rams lined up for the extra point. Inside of the uprights. The Rams offense did their job on that last drive. They moved the ball down the field almost the entire length. It was all thanks to a great passing attack. The Rams setting up now, trying to recover an onside kick. his job as the onside kick attempt is thwarted. Defense has really been the story of this game, including that last drive when they were able to come up with a fumble recovery.
Hey, look, let's give a lot of credit to the defense there. The call was absolutely right on the mark. That allowed those players to go out there and make that play.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a, you know, a little slack because they're running so fast. They're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
First down at the 22. Matthew. That's a gain of 7. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down and 3 following that nice run. And the carry to Ryan Matthews. Davis there to take him down. The Eagles have turned it up a notch with their running game today, Phil. And Matthews has been absolutely brilliant and almost impossible to bring down.
What a dominating performance by this offense today. Just coming out and out hitting the defense, giving the running back opportunities, and they are taking advantage of it.
Trying to beat the play clock. Toss to the outside. Runs it across. Touchdown. That touchdown almost assuredly was the nail in the coffin.
Oh, it absolutely was, wasn't it? And listen, the game is always won in the trenches. And what I mean by that, today the offensive line won the they won the battle. They beat the defensive line all over the field. The pass protection was tremendous, and the run blocking was very good. That's why they won the game easily.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. The Rams are ready to return the kick. Test the coverage here as he takes a knee. Todd Gurley ready for action. And a very uncharacteristic performance for him today. You can see what an effect it's had on his team when he's not performing at his usual level, Phil.
Yeah, when you go out there and you want to win a football game, who usually leads the way for to help you win that game? It's a star player. And today that never happened. It was a surprise to us, and that's the big reason why they're going to lose. Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator. A little screen pass to the halfback. He knew the defensive line was going to be charging hard. They were, and it picked up some nice yards.
Only 35 yards to the end zone. 2 minutes to go in the second half. We're back. Only 2 minutes remain in this one.
The D-line all talking. I think they're expecting run. That's why they're shifting to their left.
Tries to get the feet down, but this will be ruled incomplete.
Well, the quarterback can't get him open. He threw to the right guy that time, but the coverage was so good by the defense, nowhere to get the completion.
The Eagles with a nickel look here on defense. The Rams will take the snap from the 35. Throw it to the outside. They've got the hookup. That's another reception. Give him 2.
What a good job by the quarterback that time. He saw the defensive back inside the receiver, and he leads that receiver to the sideline on that corner route.
First down here after the completion. He'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. And methodically, he just throws it away. Breaking huddle at the 21. Takes it from the gun. Kendricks comes down with it.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside the 20-yard line, and you're down some points, you're thinking touchdown in these situations.
Quick with the catch. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry. He'll take the snap from the gun. The Rams turn the ball over on downs.
When you're going against a good quarterback and receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
A lot of things have to go wrong in any game for it to be this one-sided. But you look at the matchup at running back, and it's certainly just one more thing that stands out.
Yeah, when you run the football well, we all know you control the tempo of the game. And also, you get in all the situations that favor your offense and your defense. That's why they're blowing the other team out.
Let's go.
And the give to Ryan Matthews. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Well, this is not a surprise, Jim. This is what you do. You run the football, you play the clock. This is called managing the game, and it's all up to the head coach getting this done.
Get ready.
Second down and 7. And Matthews is taking the handoff.
Well, not many yards to get there on that play, but it doesn't matter. What a day and what a job this running back has done here.
The Eagles come to the line. The first down marker is at the 24. Here's the quick toss. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Jim, no surprise there. You got the lead. It's late in the game. You run the football. Make that clock keep ticking. And you go over these situations so many times in practice. You got to manage the clock. Know how much time you got left. They've done that well. And just keep running.
He's up over 90 yards so far on the day.
Well, he's in the NFL because of this. Because this guy can break tackles. Good job on that play.
And this will probably wrap things up here. Outside now on the toss. And they'll end up losing 4 here. Phil, before we go, how about this win? How much will this one count?
You know, Jim, all wins are nice. This one was done easy. You didn't have to sweat too much over it. You feel good, and you just enjoy the next couple days.
Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.